John Oliver waged a war.
I don't just want the Pūteketeke to win. I want it to win in the biggest landslide in the history of this magnificent competition. Pūteketeke.
Pūteketeke.
A war he won.
New Zealand's bird of the century is... the Pūteketeke.
Let's call it what it is.
Foreign interference.
Oliver put billboards up around the globe. I'm talking Paris, Tokyo, London, Mumbai, and even downtown Manitowoc, Wisconsin.
It's wonderful. It's great. I love it.
His foul play worked. A whopping 350,000 verified votes from 195 countries were cast, smashing the 2021 record of a mere 56,000. Oliver's campaign crashed the voting system, leading to a two-day delay on the winner being announced.
Pūteketeke.
The competition aims to raise awareness about New Zealand's stunning native and endangered birds. And the Pūteketeke flocked off the North Island brown kiwi, the kea, the kakapo, and even the adorable eastern rockhopper penguin. Look at those eyebrows! But let's talk Pūteketeke. Sure, it's got a great mullet. It's super cute how it carries its young. And I can't argue with their mating dance, where they puke, grab a beak full of weeds and chest bump for a while. But I've got some not-so-breaking news.
She doesn't even go here.
That's right. Pūteketeke, she gets around. It's not even native to New Zealand.
Is that a joke?
Yep.
That's pretty good.
No, it's not. You'll find it flapping around Europe, Central Asia, Africa, and even Australia. Here we call it the Australasian vested grebe. And let's just say the locals aren't impressed.
What do you make of that?
Okay, that's as angry as Kiwis get. But this will go down as another dark chapter in New Zealand's notorious Battle of the Birds.
Pūteketeke.
It's getting a bit frisky.
Ow! Ow!
Well, one Kiwi was so mad he fled the country. It's comedian Guy Montgomery! Guy, isn't this all a bit drastic, you fleeing the country over a bird vote?
Well, no, I've come here to defend our country's honour. I've come here to set the record straight. And more than that, I've actually come here to do stand-up comedy. This is purely incidental.
Oh, so it's just a bird. Why are you so outraged?
Well, look, I feel pretty good about it. I'm happy for the Pūteketeke. I'm happy for Bird of the Year in New Zealand. I think, you know, it highlights some issues perhaps to be corrected for the big comp in 2024. I've heard tell that some Australians are claiming the Pūteketeke is their own, which is typical of this, you know, this dastardly country.
Oh, no.
You know, I'm pumped up. You know, we've got a great competition. We've been running it since 2005. I see you guys pilfered the idea in 2017. Don't even have the confidence to run it annually. And, you know, our competition's so hot, you're featuring it on your television.
That is true. But let's be honest, Guy, it's a farce, this competition. Yeah. It has been for a long time. It's replete with foreign interference and corruption. And I don't say this lightly. So, for example, there was the incident where a bat got chosen.
Disgusting.
There was the other one. This was in 2019, where there were accusations of Russian interference.
Mm. Okay.
Why can't you guys run an election?
Hey, we're running it tidy. I will give you the bat win in 2021 that shocked the nation. But 2020, it was a crazy year, man. It was a weird time. People couldn't, you know, they didn't know what was heads or tails, and the bat snuck through. We'll give it that. The Russian interference, if you look at it from the perspective of, you know, the little battler that is New Zealand, pretty sick. Pretty sick to get the Ruskies in.
Guy, why don't you just claim it? You mentioned it before. We claim stuff all the time. You can claim it like we've claimed Pavlova and Russell Crowe.
You can have Pavlova's too dry. Too dry for a cake. Russell Crowe, you know, I ebb and flow on Russell Crowe. I will claim it. And also, you know, it's an Australasian, what do you call the Pūteketeke here? The Australasian something or other?
Yeah, the Australasian vested grebe. Like, what a name.
Yeah. You guys should embrace your indigenous language and the native names of birds. It's going off back home. There's a big party in New Zealand right now. I had to get out because I had to get an early night. You know, I've got a big week of stand-up comedy.
Are we still calling you lot Kiwis, or are we going to change it to Pūteketekes?
I think just for the sake of your accent, calling us Kiwis is safer ground for the Australian people. You know, if you do a year of accent training, Pūteketeke could be on the table. We don't call you the cockatoos or the kookaburras or whatever the heck.
Oh, God, that didn't sound right, kookaburra out of your mouth. But thank you for your time. Good luck with hiding in Australia.
Hey, thank you for your time. I'm the best, baby.